Good morning, dear students. Welcome to our offline class. At present, I am in 8th standard first language English class. In the previous class, we already completed the poem. Now it is the time to new poem. We have to start here. The name of the new poem is After Apple Picking. Just you have to understand, after apple picking, it is a season. In that season, how the very fruitful or very ripeful of the apples, when after the picking of those apple fruits, what will happen? That is one of the interesting story. That story is composed by Robert Frost. So we have to understand the introduction of the poet right now. So everyone should even open your textbook, page number 87. In that they are given very front page about the poet. Okay, here Robert Lee Frost, it is the full name of Robert Frost. What is the full name of Robert Frost? Robert Lee Frost. What is the duration of his period? He lived on 1874 to 1963, in between the century of 19th century. So he was belonged to romantic movement of English literature. So this is the movement, this is the period we have to consider as romantic period of English literature. Okay, we have to understand. So we already know that what is the full name of Robert Frost. Robert Lee Frost, it is the full name of Robert Frost. And what is the duration of his period? His period, he belonged to romantic English literature period, that is 1874 to 1963. Next, he was a famous American poet. Which country he belonged to? He belonged to American poet. He dealt with themes from rural life in New Zealand, USA, using the setting to examine complex social and philosophical issues. He composed so many information or so many poems about that. Those poems belonged to rural life in New Zealand, USA, and setting to examine complex social and philosophical issues. What are the major themes of the Robert Frost poems? The Robert Frost poems are main themes to examine complex social and philosophical issues. That is the highlighted point there. Just you have to understand. And his important poetical works. How many poetical works he had done? He had done so many. But in that very popular, very famous, they are given a little bit. Just you have to understand them. Here, his major important poetical works are A Boy's Will. A Boy's Will is the first one. It is composed in the year 1913. The second one, North of Boston, it is also one of the popular poem, and it is also popular collection of poetical work. So it is published in the year 1914. Mountain Interval, it is also one of the literature work, poetical work by Robert Frost. It is published in the year 1916. Then New Hampshire, it is also one of the major work. It is also written, composed in the year 1923. Collected Poems, it's the name of the book. Not only poems are there, it is a collected poems. It's the name of the book. It is composed in the year 1930. A Further Range, 1936. And A Witness Tree, 1942. As a popular and oft quoted poet means he was very famous during the time of 19th century. That's why there is a phrase they are used. What is the phrase? Oft quoted poet. Oft quoted poet means very famous poet during the time of 19th century. The next point we have to understand, that is a very one of the precious information about him. What is that? Frost was honored with the prestigious Pulitzer Prize 4 times. How many times he get that prize? 4 times. That's one of the major in the world, major award in the world. He awarded that award, Pulitzer Award, 4 times. The next one, his poetry is largely traditional in terms of meter and executes lyrical grace. So these poems, I already mentioned those poem names and according to their published year, those poems are very, very terms. They are largely traditionally in terms of meter. Meter means evaluation. When we have to be evaluated those poems, those poems contain very moral ethics. They are follow the social and rural areas problems. So those are the hiding information of the themes of the poems. The next, after apple picking, it is a poem. This poem published in the collection of North of Boston. It is a part after apple picking. It is a single poem. North of Boston. So that is the major volume book. The next is a well-known poem on man's encounter with the natural world. So here we have to understand, it is a well-known poem on man's encounter with the natural world, probing the dilemma of his experience. Because of he is one of the famous poet, but he analyzes always about the social problems, find out the social problems and solutions he had given through his poems. So this is the information we have to understand. And here the poet gives reflection on boredom and drudgery in the aftermath of the task of picking apples. After picking the apple fruits, what happened there? What kind of dull work? What kind of dungeon means lazy work? That lazy work happened there. The next, the work where the apple picker is unable to enjoy his life amid the pristine beauty of nature. When they are picking the apple fruits, at the time they are enjoying. Why? Because the nature beauty of the nature of the pristine is the name of the place. So they are very enjoying observing that scenery or the beauty of the nature. The next, what will happen? Composed in free verse in the poem is remarkable for its mood and intensity. It is also an antithesis of modern civilization, marked by the culture of exclusive work for increasing material gain to no need or no end. In that poem, he mainly focused about that Robert Frost mainly focused about the workers of the apple pickers. When they are apple picking, at that time they are very enjoying. Why? Because they are observing the beauty of the nature. At that time they are very happiness. So this is the brief information about the poet, and there is no pre-reading activity. But you have to understand, have you observed the apple tree? If you have observed, that means you should write a few lines. That is the pre-reading activity. You should write a brief note on apple tree. What do you know about the apple tree, and how is the apple? Is it tasty or not tasty, and what kind of shape it has? So you should write in your own words with 5 or 6 lines. Okay, you should show me on Saturday without fail. Okay, thank you so much.